Hello and good morning. January 3rd already, 2019. 1-3-19. Where does the year go? Good morning, Ron. So, after the two Spider-Mans that I did yesterday, I decided to dial back and go black and white with a Frank Miller Dark Knight styled Batman. Well, Dark Knight Batman. But just hit this one up with the inking, the textures, and maybe some tones. Maybe a gray wash in here. Hey, good morning, Jerome. How are you today? And I got a few other things to... family things that I need to do after this, so... can't really be here for 5 hours. Yeah. Well, probably the only reason I was telling you right now, Ron, was to hit the blacks on that inking was I think we need to work on your render style, or that type of thing. I want to get you used to angles and curves just in the black phase, but you know, no, without noodling yet. It's always best to start by simplifying the shapes and looking at the black and white and seeing what kind of patterns are there and how they form shape, or how they shape the form, rather. Let me reverse that. Yeah, towards the end of his run on Sin City, I think even he slipped back, Miller slipped back into noodling a bit too much from his original, the original one, where if it was black, it was black. If it was white, it was white. And he let that, he didn't do as much line work either. Both little noodle rendering lines and holding lines on edges. So if you take the whole thing and if you look at some of it, it looks like, I don't know, somewhere in there when he started, it looked like he was really brave, and that's the ones I like. Towards the end of this Sin City run, and I guess into like 300 and stuff, he started to render more, and that's where it began to lose me. Jerome, my thoughts on doing an Azrael Nightfall Batman. I wouldn't do it on a whim. If somebody asked me and paid me to do it, then I would do it that way. But just to pull it out of my head is something to do? No. So, I got some ink out. Kind of got a late start. That's why it was 7:30. I was deciding, you know, I just figured since I have not drawn I think I've done one like Miller-esque or this version, the older craggy thick Batman. So I just thought I would use the stream to have fun doing it. So that's why I chose, and I every intention yesterday when I was talking about Batman, I was just going to do my typical regular Batman, not the high test here. But at the 11th hour, I thought, you know, let me have some fun and do this. So that's what I'm doing. And I better get started. Yeah, like I said, Jerome, that would be one that you know, it's not going to be one that's going to come to me and I'm going to, I mean, in my head, you know, it's not going to be one that I'm going to think about and go, oh yeah, I want to do that just because, this one I will, you know, this I will, the Spider-Man drawings that I did, those were ones that I wanted to do. So, so it really is just a matter of, you know, what's kind of in my interest at the time. And I gotta say, the Spider-Man movie made a big impact on me visually, so it kind of brought a new meaning or a new level of respect of the character Spider-Man back to me that I had probably not felt in a long time. And I'm probably, I think, depending on if the people come through, I had a few people ask me about the, I put a pre-commission request out for the Dallas show and had about three people hit me up this morning for pricing and wanting commission work done. So if all of those come in, I will probably stop the YouTube full figure sale this weekend. That'll be it. So if you haven't taken advantage of that yet, you should, because I'll blast it out probably one more time tomorrow before the weekend and see what it brings. It's brought enough, but not enough that I couldn't take on some pre-commissions for the show I'll be doing in Texas at the beginning of February. And it's literally the beginning of February, first weekend, second and third. Yep, I am busy. However, I need to get busy on the better paying work. That's what I need to concentrate on. So hopefully by doing some discounted price commissions, that gives me samples to show so that when I up the price, I can show people, you know, look, this is what I'm doing. That's why. Not that the price is high, but that's why the price can be justified. So what I'm going to do here, why I'm going to have, and I guess I can call him either Batman or Dark Knight. I try to call it the Dark Knight when I'm talking about Frank's version. Old craggy, heavier, thick Batman. Gonna have the lighting coming in from both directions. The reason I'm doing this is because I'm gonna have another rain background. Yes, indeed, this will get a rain effect. towards the end of it. I've already decided that, and it'll kind of be like lightning. Is lighting him from the sides. Depends on the hero. I understand evolution and things changing as well as the next person, I think, but I also think that certain things don't need to be changed just for change. I think if it's a natural evolution, then that could be okay. But I saw a lot of characters change just because publishers thought that changing the character would drive sales up, and only to see it fail. Or do worse if they would have just left the character alone to live as it had throughout however long the character had been created. And then they kind of get caught in that trap of having to change it back or changing it again, trying to create a character that should have just been left alone. And let it go through its life cycle, and not do change just, you know, like I said, just for the fact of we need to try to manufacture sales. I don't know, Jerome. I don't know if they've actually I don't know if they've actually found the right person yet. And I haven't seen the last few bat. The last one I saw was, I think, Dark Knight. with Heath Ledger as the Joker. So truthfully, I'm not sure they have found the right person yet. While I did appreciate in the 80s the Tim Burton Batmans for their atmosphere and some of the imaginative things that he accomplished, I never warmed up to Michael Keaton in the bat suit. I know some people, you know, they're fine with it. But for me, it just, you know, I think the movie overall was good, but I just never bought him as the Batman, as the character. On the other hand, I did like Heath Ledger's Joker. But I also liked Nicholson as Joker. I think for the time, and here we go to that, you know, time thing. I think Nicholson was a wise choice. I'll say this. He was a safe choice, I think. Safe in that I think everybody knew that he was going to give a good performance, and well, let's just say with Michael Keaton being Batman, at least I got to see one of my favorite actors in a Batman movie. Hey, good morning, Jasper. Let me type in the chat room the page and password. I believe that's it. Oh, what happened? It didn't like that. All right, let me try again. don't seem right either. Let me see. I'm going to actually go to my history and find that page so I can just cut and paste it in there for you. Okay. Why is it not letting me post in a URL? That is very, very weird. Huh. Okay. Let me do this. Oh, okay. Well, Jasper, contact me if you look at the streaming window. Yeah, I know. That's very weird, though, because I'm supposed to be able to type URLs. Below the streaming window, Jasper, you should see a show more. And if you scroll down there at the bottom, it has my website, and then it also has a email. So just go ahead and contact me through my email, and I'll send you a link to the page. That sound all right? Did you hear? I don't have my headset on this morning. My neck is a little stiff from wearing it yesterday for so long. So I'm working without it, but can't believe that's interesting. Maybe I have to change a YouTube setting. I know they went through a kind of a new year refresh of some of their stuff, and maybe I have to revalidify myself again or something. I have no idea. That's pretty frustrating, though, when you're the channel owner, so to speak, and can't give out your own URLs. Yeah, Jerome. Like I said, I probably will. I'll let that sell go through the weekend until the end of Sunday, and it's only because I do have a convention coming up, and I think I'm going to get about three pieces to do for that, and I have other ones that I need to get on, so. So it's time for everybody to make a decision, including myself, about and that's not to say that it'll never be offered again, but right now is your best time because convention season for me has not started yet. Starting in February, got my first one, and after March, I think it takes off pretty good. And not gonna have that time that I might have now to do some, so. Yeah, you can share the I put it out on all my social media stuff. You can go ahead and give him the URL if you still have it and the password so he can look it over and contact me directly. So that's fine. Like I said, my main thing is I'm just going to be ending it this coming Sunday, which will be what, the 6th? So if he wants to reserve a spot, he's got till my Monday morning. And I am going to use the hair dryer to dry this ink. I just wanted to fill that black area in up there. Yeah, it is, Ron. Those were done by Kelly Jones, who I did ink a lot for 8 years, Jasper. I think I maybe inked one or two of those covers, but I didn't ink them all, so. I know sometimes the online databases and stuff might give me credit for some of that stuff. But they're not always right. By the way, Jasper, welcome to the channel. I believe this is your first time here. Okay, Ron. Let me see. I'm just going to see if I can type in here. Go, hi, Jasper. It's not letting me type. Or at least when I see it, I see like a red bar. It says error, try again. Very, very odd. Let's see, I'm just going to hit a couple of question marks. Are you all seeing my typing come in, or it's grayed out and I got an error, try again. All right, let me get rid of that. Error, try again. Huh, I think it's blocking me for some reason. Well, that's odd. Blocked from my own chat. Well, luckily I have a microphone and I usually don't type into the chat room, so. It's really odd that I can't type in my own chat. It's kind of got me thinking, where's the problem? All right. Sign in to chat, really? All right. Okay. Now let me see. I'm just going to type some random. Now I can put it in there. Okay. Wow, that's pretty bizarre. But I'm glad I got it figured out and it was something easy. So now, Jasper, I should be able to put in the room. This, which is the page, and the password. There you go. That should give you the information you're looking for. And like I said, I'm shutting that particular sale down at least for a while this coming Sunday. Sunday. Okay, Jerome, I do appreciate that. Thank you very much for sharing and helping get the word out, buddy. Oh, well, thank you. Got a little
straggler hair on this brush I need to get off.
Of course, now it's gone over there. Oh, I know what I forgot. I thought it was a little dark. I need to put this front light on. Ta-da! Much better. There, I can see better, and you all can see better. Good for everybody. Okay, Jasper. I think I heard an email come in on my phone, so that was probably you. Let me see. Yep. Okay, I got it here. I will give it a read after the stream and get back to you. Answer any questions you had or whatever. And see what we can do. So I appreciate it. And thanks to Jerome for passing on the information there. I see what you did there, Jasper. And luckily, I am doing the Dark Knight, who's a little scarred and craggy because these little marks that just got on my finger from ink will be okay. Come back here, table. All right, so raindrops. Don't know if I want to get to the background yet. Don't think I do. Probably going to get in with some whiteout on that background rain too. But I am going to do a lot of it with a brush. get filled in black. It's awful quiet in here this morning, but that's okay. I understand. It's not a bad thing. Just an observation. Actually, I like it because the Batman is a chunkier, thicker, bigger character, and I think it kind of suits him, no pun intended, a lot better for it to be a heavier, more, you know, like, I probably have a little bit too much curve here. It's probably a little bit less than what I gave it. But I think it works well for the overall feel of the character design. There's, you know, there's so many ways that it's been drawn. I'm not sure what my favorite way is. I think it depends on the artist. I think personally, when I draw Batman, when I pencil and ink him myself, I tend to gravitate more towards not having the yellow circle around the bat on his chest. I don't know. I think for me, it tends to work better that way. But again, that's just, you know, if I'm doing a drawing, I just kind of lean that way without even thinking about the other ways. I basically draw the oval. I use it as a guide to put the shape of the bat in. So I don't draw the outside oval. I draw like an inside oval. Kind of funny. I still draw that oval, and maybe that's how it really came to be, was they were drawing the oval to fit the bat shape on the chest in, and then decided, hey, let's do a secondary oval. And we can make it yellow, and it'll make this bat really pop or really stand out on his chest. You know, that's what I think I heard that. I think that they, you know, explain it as it becomes a target. And of course, if you've ever seen like a schematic drawing where they take the suit and stuff, I think they even tag it as something like that, as a, you know, a visual target that's easy enough for the bad guys to see, but it's bulletproof. So therefore, they're not taking headshots at Batman, which would not be bulletproof. Yeah, isn't that the truth, Ron? Well, that could be, guys. I don't know. I think the darker Batman look is something that I don't think DC has particularly ever, at least not to my knowledge, chased after an artist or tried to reel them in from drawing Batman. Almost like, to me, I think Batman is the one character from both Marvel and DC that has been interpreted the most by artists, and they haven't gotten, like, I don't want to say in trouble, but they haven't got, like, and now maybe they've got a wrist slap, but, you know, for the most part, everybody kind of gets to do their own Batman when you do Batman. It's almost like if they started, I think if DC started doing a specific style guide, I think they would lose a lot of artists that have had that childhood dream to work on the character. I think it would kind of lose some of its intrigue for a lot of people. Because I think that's something that, just speaking for myself, that a lot of artists kind of like, is that, there, my air conditioner, don't know if y'all were having trouble, but I was, it was on. I don't think anyone's ever, you know, gotten their take of Batman pulled completely. Now, there may have been, like, a few things, you know, like, hey, could you maybe next time not do this, or next time reel this in, or whatever. But for the most part, I think DC kind of enjoys letting artists be a little creative on Batman to a degree. I don't think internally, you know, working with Kelly with the real long ears, that wasn't, you know, that's kind of his trademark on the character for him, but he wasn't the first one to do it, the long ears. So, you know, I know he kind of extended them both in timeline and in physical extension. But to my knowledge, they never asked him to stop drawing the ears so long. No, I did not do a Batman cover. I did a pinup and a detective. I did do a Punisher cover and I did a Punisher pinup. But I never did do a Batman cover. I did the pencils to Batman 555, which while I was working on them, I thought I was, I don't know why I assumed I was going to be inking it. I just did. And then I found out that I wasn't, and I was kind of penciling it with the intention of inking it. So I, you know, at the beginning I was penciling fairly tight. And then I loosened up a bit once I got past about the first three or five pages. And then somewhere about the halfway point, I mentioned inking it, and they were like, oh no, you can't ink it too. And then it became a not so fun ordeal anymore. Had a little argument with the editor at the time, but not Denny, but the editor I was working with on it. Denny wasn't working directly with me on that. I didn't see that one, Jasper. Not familiar with that suit. But the current stuff, I think the problem with it is all the extra extraneous stuff they put on the costumes. I think there's too much clutter. Now, if a hero needs weapons and stuff, I get it, but when they start putting, you've probably heard this before, when they start putting stuff on Superman, like armor and stuff, it gets a bit like, why, you know, excuse me, he's nicknamed the Man of Steel, and you're going to put like some sort of elbow pads or knee pads or something like that on him. Nah. Again, we all have our own ideas, so not being critical of you personally, just critical of the model of, you know, what Superman is. I mean, He has a suit because he has to wear something in comics, or I guess not in this day and age. Which I think that was the idea also behind the short-lived t-shirt and jeans version of Superman. I think they had something like that out. I don't know. I kind of get some of the decisions, but I think it's like when you've got so much beautiful, wonderful history in a character, is it really necessary to start changing it now? I don't think so. I think if it's lasted this long, you owe it some respect to let it live the way it has. Okay. Now, some of these areas are going to be black. Not going to fill them in quite yet. Just wanted to get this the shapes in. Do a little erasing cleanup. And I think I'm going to think I'm going to get into some background rain. Before I get into filling in the blacks on the costumes and doing anything like that, just seems like a more logical progression of the piece. Sorry for my my big hand in the way there. Or actually, it's not so big hand, but I know on camera it probably covered the entire thing. Apologies for that. All right. So I just need to think a minute or two. I'm gonna take a sip of water. Stretch my back a minute. My biggest question to myself right now is, do I want the rain coming straight down or do I want to angle it? A big part of me wants the rain coming direct down, like it's a extreme downpour. But another part of me says then that might just make it not quite sell it as a rain. I mean, I can, but probably slant it in. And let's see. Just going to do a little I really don't want any holding line on his head here in cape. I just want the rain to develop it for me. So I'm just putting in a little bit, and then later when we get to the white, which I'm going to shake up now, because by the time I get to it, hopefully the foam will be done. Well, it foams up. When I get to the white, I want to do little, you know, like the rain's hitting his shoulders. Something cool like that. All right. So, big brush, little brush, doesn't really matter. No, I don't think so. All right, so taking off my glasses so I can get a little, kind of got to get underneath my webcam here. Yes, I do got a lot of ink on there. I thought I would have been getting a dry brush effect by now, but gonna have to maybe force it. Okay. Good morning, Dr. Kaz. Yeah, I'm the same way. Not a rain guy, but, you know, it kind of works for a good atmosphere. I was tempted to finish off Spider-Man month, but I wasn't going to be able to come up with enough ideas for Spider-Man. So I decided to let it rain. And instead of going to Gotham with a normal, my normal regular style Batman. This is one I think I've only done a commission of once before by myself, and then once with my exec, the aged, thick, dark, gritty, pissed off old man Batman, Dark Knight by Frank Miller. So I thought he would be a good choice to just mix it up a little bit and although I got to say, don't know if it's Spider-Man and that that great movie of his that's out now, or the amount of work that I put into those two pieces, or what, but they got good views, really good views on them. They've been tearing up my YouTube. I think the one Shannon picked up on Tuesday, on the 1st, was it the 1st or this, whenever I did that first one, the symbiote, that thing's over 70 views, which is my, I believe, my best performing daily. And the one I did yesterday is closing in fast. So maybe there is a little something to that webhead character that I need to pay attention to. And while I did enjoy doing those, I can tell that I'm, whenever I do something that involved again, it's gonna be I just gotta charge higher. That's the only way I can say it. That was way too much of my day for what amounted to minimum wage pay. But, you know, live and learn, or it was fun. I got a nice, well, person that got a nice piece. I got a nice, nice reaction from the fans out of it, and got some new subscribers. So all around, I'm not going to complain. I'm just going to realize that to do a full mini painting, or not even mini, but well, it's mini in size, but to do a full painting like that, gonna have to put the time in. gonna have to realize that it's not a couple hours and out, it's 4 hours on stream time before the stream, and I will do that, Ron. I will definitely keep you in mind if I got a feeling Jerome's not going to follow through on that one, though. I think Jerome's wishing he could already have that in his hands. I wish he could, too, but he's got a few more coming up, so he'll have a big art day when everything arrives. Ah, yes, the Black Panther piece is sold, and I have a full-figure Black Spider-Man to do for the gentleman who bought it that I have to get to before I can get to yours, among with a few other things. And that was something I was thinking of, that what I really need to do this weekend is sit down, see what I have to do, map out my by then I should know if I got anything secured from the people in Texas as far as pre-show commissions, and basically just kind of make a calendar of when I'm gonna have each piece started and done, and kind of go by that. It will be like Christmas for Jerome Oliver. Oh, is it? It's on your phone, Jerome? Or did you stretch it out on your desktop or tile it? Or both? Yep, that's one thing. You see a lot more in the scan than you can on a stream. I know when Ron first came here to the studio and picked up and saw the other originals laying around, picked up his and saw the others, he was amazed by what was getting lost in the stream. But nothing I can really do about that. Except wish that streaming quality was a little bit better, but well, thank you, Jerome. Ron knows. Ron's got a fistful of them. Ron has a fistful of them. Okay, so I was going to say no need for a big wash, but then I did realize his suit is going to be a dark gray, so let's see. I'm looking at my brushes here. That's the red one.
Let's see what I got here. Let's see what's coming. Yeah, too light. So I'm just going to get some ink and dip it in and start seeing what, if I need more water, less. Well, I don't need less water. That's a good color. It actually may even be a bit light for his suit. That's what I was thinking when I said that, Ron. But I didn't want to say it. I figured I don't want you driving off the highway. I figured you would be on it in a minute, so to speak, Trebek.
That's my friend from the office down below. Okay. Okay. Let's see. Yeah, I'm trying to decide. I should probably fill the blacks in. That's going to help me on this. I need to do that. The problem I'm having right now is I'm probably gonna put a light tone of wash on his face but leave highlights. I'm trying to decide if I should put some tone on his cape. I'm gonna leave up on the shoulders a bright white, and I don't know if I should put tone on the rein and then go in with white pen so it's kind of black, gray, and white. Or not. So I think filling in blacks will it's one of those things that I haven't decided. So I think filling in the blacks on this one is definitely going to help that decision. So without further ado, let's get these filled in. Thank you.
Now it's looking, that's leading my eye better. It's amazing what filling in those blacks will do. Boy, that's a nice shape. I'm digging that. I still think background left with just white paint is going to be my final choice. That's what I was leaning towards. This is kind of reinforcing that because I kind of want the dark, and then I don't want it to be like he's wearing a glowing cape, but I do want it to be bright. And the fact that, let's say, lightning is off panel here. That's why the sky would just be streaky, because it's being lit up by lightning strikes. So as Ron noted, this is up for dibs today. The dib price, as my fingers get a little tacky there, the dib price for this is $60. The steal of the year happened yesterday, and Jerome was the recipient of that, although he has placed an order for more product, so it went to a good guy. We'll be doing some more commissions, not the daily ones. He's getting some, taking advantage of the full figure YouTube subscriber special, which will be, I'm going to shut that down on after, I'll let it run through Sunday night. Monday morning when I get into my office, and as you all know, I am up very early, usually 4:15. That's what I've been setting my my alarm for, just to give me that extra 15 minutes. I don't know if that really matters, Jerome. This is ink wash, so it's black and white, but in the big scheme of things, it's another layer of work for me, for, you know, the artist. So I would still say it's considered black and white because it's, you know, it's tonal, it's tones of that, but had I not put tones on, it becomes less work, not as much to do. So that's just kind of a brief, you know, small explanation. Now I'm gonna make sure this ink is really dry. Let's see. Okay, let's see. I'm going to read this. Ron says, you know, if Jerome had a gun yesterday, he could have faced life in jail.
LMAO. Jerome replies back, "Why do you say that, Ron? LOL." And then Ron replies, "It's a joke about how that was a steal." Dun, 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 dun. That's for my son, Jacob. He never watches these all the way through, but maybe when he's older and I'm not here, he'll sit down and binge. And binge watch Dad drawing. And yes, that actually is another reason I kind of like doing this, is so that in the future, the little guy can have a library of pops at work. Of course, he may not care at all, so it's the thought. I'm thinking about him. How about that? Thinking about my little boy. And Bella might enjoy it also. Hey, good morning, Don. Thank you for the compliments on The Dark Knight here. I will mention, since you came in, Dibs has not been called yet. It's been bantered about, but nobody has committed 100%. It's only been brought up. So, if you are so inclined, sir, it is dibbable. Boy, I knew that was going to be tough to say. And if not, enjoy this stream, right? Because in the end, we're all here to have a good time. And I do appreciate you coming in this morning and keeping me company with the rest of the people in the house. I think we have Ron, Jerome, and Dr. Kaz. That's who I can remember off the top of my head right now who are still here at this not so early morning. You know, I never read, I read the first Dark Knight. I didn't read 2 and 3. But visually, I always liked what Miller did with the elder, grumpy, crotchety Batman. I thought it was just visually really well done. The first one, the original Dark Knight, I kind of got an interesting story about that. I remember getting the first prestige format book
And one night before I went to bed, I was paging through it and I was like, yeah, you know what? I'll read it until I get tired and go to sleep. Well, story goes, I didn't go to sleep. I woke up and I was reading that thing, and man, I'll tell you, it caught my attention early in and held it, and it was a really worthwhile read. Wasn't one of those books that I thought would just put me to sleep, and I should have known better because I had been following Frank's work since he was drawing Daredevil, not even the writing. And then when he got onto the writing, I even liked it more. So shouldn't have surprised me, but it kind of caught me off guard, you know. Now the follow up to that is, living here in Daytona Beach, spring break, I was over at the hotel that was the Happening Hotel, which had the nightclub in it, 600 North. And they had this, and they still do, this nice pool deck. And that's where they had a lot of concerts and stuff going on throughout spring break. And I was still a young man then. This was whenever Dark Knight came out. So anyway, they were having some sort of, I don't know what to call it. They were, college kids were getting free stuff from companies that, you know. So I just kind of fell in and started following, and next thing I know, I run into a DC booth that had DC reps there, they had a stack of Dark Knight, the second issue of the prestige format, and they were giving those out, and I can't remember the people who were there now. However, it was interesting that I actually got to pick up the second book from them direct. I talked to them. I introduced myself. They actually knew who I was, because they were in, what department were they? I can't, I keep wanting to say licensing, but I guess it was kind of a customer relations, or I'm missing the, consumer goods or not. See, it was something internal that DC had. And this was kind of their team that they would send out to trade shows and stuff. Anyway, I introduced myself. They knew who I was. Asked me had I read Dark Knight, and I told them, yep. And they said, but you don't have the second issue. And I said, no, I don't. It's not. And it wasn't. It was not out on the stands yet. So snag me a copy of that and got to read it before my friends who were actually comics fans, not just the college kids who probably, for the most part, just threw them away. Or maybe read them and didn't think much of it. But I gotta say, truthfully, that to me was a good move on DC's part. to appear at something where there were college kids and that they had something like a Dark Knight at the time that was probably pretty good for a college kid as a, you know, to get them interested in comics to give. So kudos to DC for that. Now, I have heard that the follow-ups to the original Dark Knight are good. I just haven't read them. So therefore, I have no opinion on whether they're good or bad or indifferent. That's why I had to fill the Black Sin run. So I could get that cape, and I think I love being able to look at the camera at what I'm working at because it can help me make decisions, such as giving this just a tad more lighter shade. Let's swing it back into the dark, blend it. Nope. Not going to touch it. I'm going to let it happen. Actually, now my ink water here, I think, is a nice flesh tone. Well done. It is available. I see you said you're tempted. So I will continue to tempt you as I work on it, hopefully. There is a light color of wash on this, which I'm starting with, so I know it doesn't appear to be there, I don't think, but it is. Actually, it's so light, I think I'm going to use it. As a base for even the teeth. I don't want them to be like, I don't want his teeth to suddenly look like they're so bleached white that they're fake. Let me go ahead and tone his face. I want those white eyes, though, to stay like that. And I can give it a dry. Okay. Now, hopefully,
Hopefully I can exercise the restraint that I need here. And give his face a second value on it and not overdo it. That is a very tough thing for me to not, for me to hold back once I kind of start. I can get lost in this technique. So I'm going to do a first pass. I want it to be a nice loose wash. And then I'm going to stop. I promise. I'm going to stop. And I'm going to let it kind of sit in my head for a minute and contemplate it. So here we go. I just got to make sure that my little drips and drabs all kind of go in the right direction. This is what I'm looking for here. These nice little pooling dark areas. That to me is like, when I get that, that really makes for a nice effect. Almost there. Almost. Pull up here. Okay, stop. Hammer time. I had to do it before someone else would.
right, so I'm gonna stop there. I was gonna say and let it dry, but I can help that process along. Also good for pressing paper. Let's see, which way do I need to go here? Up. Into the light. Into the light. All right, now I need a little bit under his nose. Because I forgot to do that. And remember, as I said at the beginning, I want the light to be coming from the sides. So now I can go back in. Play around a little bit. And still have that nice base there. Voila. Don't need a server. Okay. All right. I am going to take a quick break down to the restroom and let this settle a little bit. I might do that Batman who laughs tomorrow. And probably will stay black and white with the ink wash on it. I don't think there's a lot of color in it from what I've seen, is there? Or does he have the red on his lips where the red is like kind of like, in fact, Ron asked me earlier, that reminded me of the new Joker. Don, yes, it's 60. And I'm gonna put some white out on, I'm fixing to do some rain effect where it's hitting the back of him. Thank you, Don. You're the man. I am gonna type that in the room. Ibs. And I appreciate it very much, Don. Well, thank you. This was personally for me, it was a piece that when I came in today, I knew I had mentioned I was going to do Batman. And I got to thinking, you know, I could do my regular Batman that I'm used to doing. And then I got to thinking, I've only done the Dark Knight style Batman twice. Once on a sketch cover by myself, the other on paper
where I inked over my exact sketch. That's it. So this is like my Dark Knight 3. So congratulations. Yeah, let me run to the restroom. I'm sure you will. and then when I get back, wow. Sound like someone fell down the stairs out there. When I get back, I'm going to go in with my whiteout and add some rain bouncing off of him. And may even do a little bit of the stipple rain effect to get the smaller dots. I'm just going to add some kind of bigger ones that I can put in that are hitting. So it's going to be a nice effect. I will be right back. It will go. That's right. You do have one. All right. Since I'm... If you hear anything in here, I can't mute it because I don't have my headset and mic on. I'm just going through the camera. But I will be right back.
The car sounds good. Yeah.
All right. As you can probably hear me trotting in, I am back. Finish off my water. And time to get out. I think the white ink will do. And there it is. I shook it up once this morning already, so it would hopefully have some of the bubbles gone, but I see they're still there, but that's okay because now what I do
let's put it in my little palette. So I don't have to dip the brush through the bubbles and it gets all over. Oh, thank you, Don. Appreciate it very much. All right. Okay. All right. And I'm looking at a Monday mail as normal, Don, so I'm pretty sure I have your email or your email. I know I have your email. Pretty sure I have your physical address still on hand here. And this is how we get the bigger drops, literally by putting them in individual. When you splatter them, you cannot control them as well. But I, like I said, I probably am going to add a layer of splatter to this also. But I want to, first of all, get the bigger ones and control them. Because while I like the randomness of the splatter pattern, I still like to make sure that some of these are where I want them to be. Does that make sense? I think so. Well, I, you know, that could work, Ron. Okay, Don, I will. And thank you again for picking this up today. Like I said, it was one that I just, you know, I really did. That's why I had totally planned on starting at 7. But I wound up starting at 7:30 because I needed to get a little reference out and see a little bit of Frank. A little bit of Miller's approach to this, a little bit of looking at what he and Klaus had done. So It was definitely, for me, it was a, you know, I could do this, but you know what? Let's switch it up and let's go the other way. So I guess it was timed right for both of us. And I'm beginning to wonder, as this comes together, if I actually need splatter. I don't need it over his face. A little bit would be nice. If I get too much, well, I don't need any down. I could put some down. I wish I had my toothbrush here. I mean, my I do have a toothbrush here, but what I mean is a toothbrush that I use for splatter. I need to bring one of my old ones down here. That becomes a mess, though. And on a live stream of after doing a toothbrush deal, I wouldn't want to touch my computer or anything to turn anything off. So at least with splatter, the way I do it now, I just tap the brush and let it go. Toothbrush, I can at least aim it a bit. I will ask Don when I get to a point here where I think it's wrapped up if he wants me to take it any further. But I kind of like the idea of seeing the face, so I'm not real. If Don wants my opinion, I'll give it to him now. I'm kind of enjoying what's down. So I'm leaning more towards, you know, if this was just me, leaving it as it is. Let's get some more hitting his head. Need some more white. Pow. Bouncing off Batman's head and ears, the rain dances with the dark night. I'm getting poetic. Hey, Don, I also... I didn't know that you had gotten art from me some time ago. I mean, maybe as much as 10 years ago or something like that. I didn't remember that. I was on Comic Art Fans, and sometimes I like to search myself along with other people and see what's going on. And I can't remember what the piece was that from your collection that you had gotten from me. It seemed like a pretty good time ago. Do you remember what I might be thinking of, Don? What piece of art that? It was an older piece, I'm sure, if that helps you any. Yeah, I like it as it is, too. I don't think I need to... to kind of put any more randomness here. The problem with that is if it gets out of control,
You got a mess. Although the randomness is nice, I'm liking the, you know, hand done splatter. How's that? I would not do this like if I had a book to do, but for this drawing, it's perfect. Vampire Batman, that's what it was. You know what? I thought, because when I saw that, I thought that had went to some guy in Europe. And that was the one where I did the black colored pencil in the background, and it turned out really, really cool. No, you. Yeah, that when I saw that piece and I saw your name attached to it, I just kind of laughed, and I really thought that had went to a guy in Europe. That piece I remembered very well upon seeing it. And I was very happy with the way it turned out. And, you know, it's one of those ones I can look back on and still like. So congratulations. You, I remember when I did that, doing the colored pencil work, and I was worried that I was going to like mess it up and have to redo the whole thing. So thank you for that, Don. And I think we're going to call that done. Might add a few more random speckles of rain here up in this darker spot. However, this is where the problem becomes is you know, I could do this all day long. And I'm sure some people do. It's kind of relaxing. But I think that's enough.
Hey, Tater, good morning. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. AG, how you doing? Yep, just putting the finishing touches on this Dark Night in the Rain. Now that song's going to get in my head. The one Jared put in there. Speaking of Jared, idea, guys. Idea. Thank you, Jerome. Thank you, everybody. Should I try to get Jared for tomorrow and do an evening stream? Should I? I'm still doing the morning. I'm still doing tomorrow morning. I'm just looking on, looking for some input on a Friday evening. That would be morning for you, Jerome. I will see. Ron, you want to come in on a Friday night for an hour or so? I'll send out a text today and see if anybody, Craig, Pat, Jared, you, Zablo, Thanks, Tater. I appreciate it. Twitter and Facebook. More so on Twitter because Facebook can be a hassle sometimes. Twitter seems to be easiest. But if you're a subscriber, go in and hit the little bell notification and your phone, or if you're on Chrome or whatever, it will show you when I'm live. I don't know if it gives a notification when I create a live event. Maybe somebody in the room could tell you if, like this morning, it said I was going to stream this at 7:30. I don't know if you got a notification on that. Thank you again, Jerome. All right. Well, what I'm going to do then is before I sign off here today, while I got a group of people in here, I may or may not do the Batman Who Laughs or whatever. If anybody wants to prepay, meaning, you know, they want to secure a drawing for tomorrow, let me know now. If it's full color like I did yesterday to that extreme, it will not be $50 or $60. It will be more like $100. So just be aware that took me a lot of time and the return wasn't enough. And I'm not blaming any, this is not a negative thing. It was my fault. I got involved in it and loved the turnout of it. And so did the people that saw it on Facebook and Twitter. So I'm more than happy, but I just can't justify that much work on a piece for 60. I would have to bump that up to 100. Thank you.
Dr. Kaz, do you want me to do you a Spider-Man? Am I hearing that? Spider-Man Friday? I'm going to wait for Dr. Kaz to answer. Actually, usually securing a drawing, Jerome, I just saw your, is 50. If you pre-purchase, it's 50. Day of is 60. And for what you got yesterday, it's got to be 100. I can't let those go for less anymore. Full color is, it's a lot more work and time and thought. And they are beautiful. You're going to love it. All right. So I will give another minute or two because I know everything here is on a delay. If not, I will just think of something later. And, you know, if it doesn't sell, I got a convention coming up and I need some art for that. So I'm good taking these small drawings to shows because gives me something else to sell at my table, and they usually go. No, I, you know, if I do a tribute to Stan, I've got an idea for something else that is, I don't really want to say, so... It's nothing major that I can't say through a company like Marvel or anything like that. It's just my own personal little tribute to Stan. And that's, I'll just say along with a few other people or characters. So that's about all I'm going to get into there. Yeah, AG. I did the background with my number three brush and this steel ruler. That was it. And then, of course, you saw me putting in the whiteout rain. So, you know. We will talk about that, Jerome. I'm looking. Thank you, everybody. Could be a Spider-Man tomorrow. I have been having a lot of fun doing Spider-Man. And I truthfully almost did a Venom painting. Little mini painting this morning, like a profile type deal, so I could really have fun with the tongue. Straight on, it's kind of tough. Let me think about it. If Dr. Kaz is still in the room, favorite Spider-Man villain. Okay, Ron. Maybe a villain is due. Haven't had a villain in a while. That's why I was kind of thinking Venom, you know, with the whole Spider-Man thing. And even though the Venom movie kind of tanked, the DVD is out now, I guess, or has been out since last week. Maybe longer. I'm not 100% sure. Anyway, all right, everybody, thank you again. Hey, Mike Cross. Looks like Zabo.
Mike Cross gets in at the goodbye.
Hey everyone, on your way out, do me a favor.
Hit the like button if you enjoyed this.
Leave a comment later if you're catching this on a replay. If you have questions or comments, please don't forget to leave them. I do appreciate them all. So I will see about a Friday evening stream. I'm going to send a text out to my gang. And I will be back tomorrow. Hopefully 7 a.m. And I should know by then if we're going to do a Friday night stream also. I'm just trying to think that could be some fun. Because the last one... was I doing the Black Panther on the last one? Can't remember. I might do another smaller piece on a Friday stream tomorrow night. Might do two. But thank you, Mike. I think it did come out very nice. Don picked this one up. So he called dibs on it and picked it up. And I'm going to make sure the white is dry before I put it on the scanner bed. And get a nice scan of it. And so I will at least see everybody that shows up tomorrow morning. I'm shooting for the 7 o'clock start. This morning it was 7:30. Tomorrow it could be as early as 7 or as late as 8. Boy, that was a rhyme. Anyway, we'll see where that goes. And then a Friday night. I'm going to see if I can get the gang together. And if I go into Friday night, I might do another smaller pencil and ink and maybe color piece. All right, everyone. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Again, if you'd like to share this with your social media, there's a share button. I'd appreciate it. We did hit 121 subscribers, I believe, from, I think, yesterday. I don't think I was over 120, so I'm at 121 now. Looking forward to that 150 on to 200. Slowly growing. Have a great day. Take care of yourselves. Be good. Make it count. And see you all tomorrow. Bye for now.